Hi everybody, it's Halo 4 Tutor with another Halo 4 gameplay commentary. As always, I'm bringing you my signature tips and tricks to help you start winning more often and having a lot more fun while you're doing it. I've been on vacation for several days at the beach with my wife. I had a great time. It was very relaxing, very refreshing, but it's good to be back on Xbox Live, back to YouTube, posting new videos. I want to thank everyone for your loyal subscription. Thanks for coming back to my channel day after day, watching my videos, checking out the new ones, leaving your comments, leaving your feedback. I really appreciate all of your loyal support over the years, and thanks for tuning in, and I hope you had a great holiday. I really do, and you know, whatever you celebrated, I hope you had a great time, and I wish you all the very, very best in the upcoming new year. I'm playing with some good friends of mine from the Halo KTS crew. They've got a YouTube channel. If you haven't seen it, I've spotlighted several of their videos on my channel, and they've got a lot more terrific content on their own channel. If you haven't checked them out, please make sure to do so. I know that they really appreciate your views and your subscriptions, and they really do a fantastic job. That's Halo KTS. And one of my friends with the Halo KTS crew is Kiba. He's driving the Gauss Hog here. And we really go on a nice tear. You know, he has a very good approach with the Gauss Hog. He realizes that the Gauss turret has very incredible range. And so he plays very conservatively. And by doing so, you can see we've started off the game. I get a triple kill killing spree to start things off. And we're going to push that all the way up to a rampage medal before we're taken down. And so it's very effective driving. And you can see his approach. He kind of goes from side to side, from one bridge to another, staying in the blue territory throughout the entire game. He never pushes up into the red side of the map, and it really pays off. In a lot of other games where I play with random players, oftentimes I see players jumping into the Gauss Hog and immediately rushing over onto the opponent's side of the base immediately. And shortly thereafter, what I normally see is they get stunned with a plasma pistol or a plasma grenade. They get taken down, they get hijacked, they get knocked over, and usually the Gauss Hog is wasted because they only get two or three kills before they're getting destroyed. But the way that Kiba is driving here, you can see that you can really earn some prolonged killing sprees without endangering the safety of this vehicle. Because for one thing, the red team constantly is pushing over to our side of the map, and so we're able to kill a lot of players over here. When they're in our territory, we don't need to push over to the other side. You just need to be patient, let the other players come to you in some circumstances, and that's certainly the case with the Gauss Hog here. A lot of times people think that just because it's powerful that it's invulnerable. That's not really the case. You want to kind of you know, play conservatively with this vehicle and protect it, because it's a very powerful weapon, in my opinion, the most powerful weapon in this game. Now, you want to take a very similar approach with the tank, which is the second most powerful weapon in this map. And with the tank as well, you don't need to push over into the enemy territory. You know, I had another game the same day as this one where I got in the tank and I got another rampage. I was like back-to-back games with rampages because I was very conservative with the tank. I didn't push across the bridges. I stayed in our side, and I was able to get a lot of long-distance kills with the tank, as well as get a lot of kills with players who are pushing over onto our side of the map. Here I've got a killing frenzy and a second triple kill of the game, so things are going very, very well for me. And again, thanks to Kiba with his excellent driving. Now, the last tip I'm going to give you in this video is when you're driving, make sure that you're communicating with one another as to where you're going, where the enemy players are, and by doing so, you can pick up a lot of additional kills. Look at that. Oh, what's that? Did I get a third triple kill of the game? Doing very, very well here. But one of the best ways to communicate I've found with the drivers is to use the clock system. And so whether you're gunning or driving, if you're talking about a player that's straight ahead of the vehicle, that's at 12 o'clock. So you could say there's an enemy at 12 o'clock. Or if there's a player directly behind you, the vehicle, that's 6 o'clock. If it's off to the right, that's 3 o'clock. And off to the left, that's 9 o'clock. So you can kind of think of yourself as standing at the center of a clock and looking outward towards the numbers. This is a very effective approach that you can use to communicate with one another when you're driving vehicles. Additionally, if you're gunning and your shields get taken down like mine were right there, I was calling out to Kiba, telling him my shields are down. He found the safest spot he could until my shields could come back and we're back out and working the other players. As promised, I'll finish the game with a rampage medal, and I want to finish off with a poll question today. My poll question is, what are your New Year's resolutions? Have you set any goals for yourself for the upcoming year? And if so, what are they? I find that when you share your goals with other people, you're much more likely to accomplish them. So for me personally, in 2013, I want to finish my book, get it published, and I also want to complete my applications to grad school and get accepted into a new program. So those are my goals. I want to hear what yours are for 2013. Please make sure to share them down in the comments below. Thanks for watching, everybody. This is Halo 4 Tutor signing out. I'll see you next time.